Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He would have killed me once he found the repository, if not before. I had no choice.
You're right. You had no choice. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. Here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
Search the area! Must be here somewhere.
We must be getting closer.
Give us Ranrok. We'll be safe with our progress. You can't stop us.
I'm
between us and him. We need to move it.
I shall handle it. One moment. Let's go. To finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Listen, more goblins up ahead.
Such one less human to worry about.
Haven't brought us much luck so far.
Rebellion. We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Stand up this way! We shall make it! We made it.
I'm relieved we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I plan to keep the repository as it is.
I'm pleased to hear that. I've been thinking.
What is it, Professor?
I spent all year trying to keep our journey a secret from everyone, including Professor Weasley. But now I wonder if I should have shared it with her, and the others, sooner. Trusted them more. The Keepers wanted this secret to be locked away forever. How long will you keep it?
The Keepers were right. The risk of using this magic is too dangerous. It is my responsibility alone to keep it safe.
I understand, but you are not entirely alone. I will do all I can to help you.
God. The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you're two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either.
Somehow protecting the dragon.
Thank you.
would have loved you, my young friend. The wizarding world could not be in more capable hands.
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
I can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait. What are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrok's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the Loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrok, Isadora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrok. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her. And she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more.